Google wants to help you hide your IP address when you're surfing the internet. How? They're baking in proxies into their Chrome browser. That's kind of weird. A little crazy, actually. Chrome is calling it their IP protection feature. And it involves running their own proxy, which they're calling the privacy proxy. Private, as long as Google doesn't look at your stuff. We'll talk about that here in a bit. In fact, it's actually pretty easy to run your own proxy. I'll show you how to do that. Check the timestamps, it'll take about 2 minutes. But first, let's talk about proxies. They're great, and they've been around for a long time, helping people hide their IP address and maintain a bit of privacy. But what is it? How does it work? When you visit a website, that website can see your IP address, which can tell them a lot about you. According to Google's own document, your IP address makes it feasible to associate what you're doing with where you've been. And why that's dangerous is over time, all that information can be combined to create a unique, persistent profile about you. And they can use that to track your activity across the web. And unlike cookies, which we can opt out of, IP address tracking, it's more covert. You can't just opt out. It just kind of happens. So this is why people use proxies. A proxy is just a server that sits in the middle of the communication between you and the website. The proxy server will handle the communication between you and that website. And instead of the website seeing your IP address, it'll see the proxy server's IP address, hiding yours, preventing it from tracking you, learning you, knowing you, using you, and all that other creepy stuff. It's kind of like when you're in a fight with your friend Bob, and you want to tell him something. But you can't. You're mad at him, right? So you tell your friend Stacy to tell him. And then he tells your friend Stacy to tell you, yada yada yada, Stacy's a proxy. That's what I was trying to say. You can also use a proxy to travel the world. You want to be in France? Put your proxy in France. And suddenly, you're French. Or Stacy is. And because websites only see Stacy, they think you're French. And you can access everything the French internet has to offer. All that geo-block content. But don't get too excited. Google isn't going to allow this with their proxy. But you can certainly do it with your own. Again, I'll show you how. Now, if you've seen enough VPN-sponsored ads on YouTube, you're probably thinking, isn't this just a VPN? Are we talking about the same thing? No. While sharing similar goals, the main difference between a VPN and a proxy is a VPN will actually encrypt your data over a secure tunnel. While a proxy won't encrypt anything, they'll just forward it over, not changing anything about your data. And because the proxy isn't worried about encrypting your data, it's typically much faster. Encryption takes time, it's a bit heavier. So when you think proxies, think fast. And when you're thinking about hosting your own server, hosting a proxy server is much less resource intensive versus hosting a VPN server, which again has to encrypt traffic. But when we're talking about hiding your IP address, they both help you. Now, let's talk about Google running a proxy. Have you ever heard of a man-in-the-middle attack? It's a hacking technique where a hacker will sit himself in the middle between you and the website you're trying to visit, and he tries to steal your information. He sees everything going back and forth, he can observe it, and possibly take it. It sounds kind of like what Google's about to do, right? They're putting themselves in the middle of our traffic, and they have the potential to see everything. Now, I'm not saying Google is going to do that. I'm just saying the potential is created by doing that. And let's be honest, does Google really need to do that? Don't they already see all of our traffic? But to put us at ease, according to their document, one of the core requirements of their privacy proxy is that the proxy will not be privy to the contents of the traffic. So they're like, we're not gonna look at it, trust us. You know what I mean? And again, this does open up a ton of concerns, some that even Google recognizes. They're like, hey, yeah, about that, like right here. The first concern, and this is a pretty big one, is what if the proxy server owned by Google that has all of our stuff going through it, what if it gets hacked? Think about it. If you're a hacker, suddenly you don't need to try and hack thousands, millions of individuals. All you gotta do is hack one of Google's proxy servers and you get all that information, potentially. Another one is denial of service. What if the hacker doesn't want to steal the information, they just want to watch the world burn? So they will try to take down these Google proxies through a DDoS attack or distributed denial of service attack. And if everyone's using these proxies to go to the internet and access everything, that impacts stability of the entire internet. Now sure, someone like me and maybe you could figure it out and be like, you know, yeah, that's because of that Google proxy. Let's just not use it for now. Other people won't realize that and they'll think, oh, I guess the internet died. You know what I mean? It's that single point of failure mentality. You don't want that. And then also going through Google proxies could disrupt a lot of the defenses that we already have for online attacks. Google will effectively be changing the way the internet works by having a lot of people go through its proxies. I won't go deep into that, but just know it will change things. So to mitigate those concerns, they will require authentication to their proxy, which will require a Google account, in which auth tokens will be issued and redeemed at the proxy. They will also be using blinded signatures so they can't identify your traffic and tie it to who you are. And to limit DDoS attacks, they'll be rate limiting tokens per account and having token expiry. I like saying the word expiry, it makes me feel British. And then one more thing here. This is actually kind of cool. So good job, Google. And they are promising they're gonna do it. It's in their roadmap, but they're considering, I hope it's more than a consideration, using two hops for improved privacy. So right now the proposed plan would be a Google-owned proxy that we would all go through. Again, our concerns. See the concerns from earlier. They're talking about adding an extra hop, another proxy. So we'll have two total proxies between us and our website. And the second proxy will be run by someone else that's not Google. A CDN or a content delivery network, maybe Cloudflare or Akamai. Google will still run the first hop, but the second will be someone else, ensuring that neither proxy can see both the client IP address and the destination. Which is funny because this kind of sounds like the Onion network, the Tor network, the dark web, and how they obscure identities and keep people anonymous through multiple hops, onion relays. So I think this actually could be pretty cool as long as they take their consideration into action. We'll see. And then as I mentioned earlier, GeoIP. One of the benefits of a proxy is that we can appear to be from anywhere in the world on the internet, which is pretty cool. Now with Google's proxy, they're gonna have to comply with local laws and regulation that have to do with content localization. So the privacy proxy will assign IP addresses that represent the user's coarse location, or I guess approximate location, including their country. And they do have a document on their GeoIP approach for IP protection. Here's what the map will look like. So I do get it, they do need to comply with laws. All the more reason to use your own proxy. So when can we expect to see this? How's it gonna work? When will the world drastically change with proxies? It's gonna be a slow rollout, a phased approach. Initially, it'll be opt-in only. So you'll have to actually turn the setting on yourself. And in phase zero, it'll be one single Google-owned proxy. And it will only proxy requests to Google-owned domains. The test will only be US-based IP addresses, and only a small percentage of clients will be automatically enrolled into the initial test. And again, part of their security features is that a user must be logged in to Chrome in order to generate that user token to authenticate with a proxy. So currently, in Google Chrome, we're in 1.18, and we can expect to see this start happening between M1.19 and M1.25. And there's the flag name for that particular setting. So when it comes out, be looking for that. So honestly, I'm kind of excited about this because Google is helping out with privacy for most people. It's a good step because most people are not going to run their own proxy, but you're not like most people. You are going to run your own proxy right now. It's so crazy, so fast, let's do it. And come on, I mean, honestly, wouldn't you rather own your own proxy versus Google doing it for you? I want to own my own privacy. And I'm actually going to show you two ways to run a proxy. The first one is ridiculously easy. It's always been there right next to you. And the second one is more robust. It actually kind of operates like a VPN. It's a proxy, but it will also encrypt your traffic. It's called shadowsocks, which kind of sounds like a superhero cat. I'm down for that. For both options, all you'll need is a Linux-based server. It doesn't even have to be big. It can be super tiny. And for my Linux server, because I want to be anywhere in the world, I'm going to spin mine up in the cloud with Linode by Akamai. Now, as you can see, I do run a ton of Linode servers in the cloud. I use them for all my projects. But anyways, let's create one real quick. I'm going to run the latest version of Ubuntu that they offer. And region, this is where it gets fun. Where am I going to be today? I want to be in Osaka. I'm actually going to Japan in about 3 weeks, 2 weeks, for a month. So I'm practicing. So I'll be in Osaka. I'll do the shared CPU and the smallest plan they have, just $5 a month. I'll name it Japan Proxy, put a password in, and click on create. And within moments, I'll have my very own proxy server in the cloud in Japan. My Linux server is done brewing. I'm going to go ahead and access it real quick. Going to grab my SSH command, copy that, launch my terminal here in Windows. It'll be the same in Mac and Linux. Paste that in, hit enter, accept all fingerprints, and we're in. Now this is gonna blow your mind. One of the best ways to run a proxy is just through having SSH. So what I just used to access the server, SSH or secure shell, is the same thing we'll use to set up a proxy. And when I say set up, I mean like, it's done. As long as you have open SSH installed, which if you access your server that way, it already is. Just to make sure, we'll try it out. apt install open SSH-server. See, mine's already installed. All you gotta do is enter that command, see if it is. If it isn't, install it, we're good to go. Now, that's all I have to do. I'm just gonna set up my clients, my computers. So, phone and computers. I don't know why I said that. I'll start with Windows. And here in Windows, I do recommend using Firefox with a proxy, mainly because I could not get it to work with anything else. So, launching Firefox, let's just do a little test real quick. Let's do a what's my IP address. Now, I'm not gonna let you see it because my editor's gonna blur it out, right, Nick? But looking at whatismyipaddress.com, you can clearly see that I am in Dallas, Texas. What do you say we change that? Now, our first step in setting up this proxy is establishing an SSH tunnel. So all we're gonna do, it sounds scary, but it's not. We're gonna launch our terminal here in Windows. So we'll use the SSH command. I told you, it's all SSH. And we'll do the option dash or tick D. And we'll type in a port. We'll just do 1337. What this is doing is powerful. It's opening up a SOCKS proxy, a proxy protocol that is awesome. It'll do TCP, UDP, whatever you want. We'll then do a dash capital N, which is telling it to not execute remote commands. We're just forwarding ports. And then we'll do a dash capital C to compress the data over our tunnel to save bandwidth. And then finally, our proxy server. Now getting back to Linode, I'm gonna grab my IP address of my proxy server, and I'll say my username, which is root, at my proxy server. Now let's go ahead and do this. Ready, set, go. Hit enter, accept all fingerprints, put your password in, and you're probably waiting like, okay, now what? Yeah, it's done. The tunnel's created, it's open. And with the tunnel created, now we're going to just tell our computer to use itself as a proxy. What? Let me show you. So here in Firefox, I'm gonna go to settings. Let's go in my little dialog here and go to settings. And I'll search for proxy. There it is. Just click on proxy settings and network settings. And here I'm gonna click on manual proxy configuration. And all I'm gonna worry about is the socks host. That's what we're running right now. There I'm gonna type in local host, which means we're gonna look at ourselves for the proxy. And we're gonna tell it the port that we just used. 1337. So we created the tunnel to our proxy server, and now we're telling our browser to use ourselves and go over that tunnel for internet. It'll make sense. Watch this. I'll click OK, and that's it. That's all we had to do. So now, over here on what's my IP address, if I refresh this, we are in Japan. Do you see that? If I go to Google, I bet it'll put things in Japanese for me. Yep, look at that. I am loving this. See, I just traveled across the world. And when you're done with the proxy, of course, change your proxy settings in Firefox. Just say no proxy for now. And then if you go back to your terminal, just hit control C and your terminal's closed. Or not your terminal, your tunnel is closed. The process is very similar on Ubuntu. Setting up my SSH tunnel and changing my proxy settings. I can do this globally inside of Ubuntu to where everything goes across it. Specifying localhost and port 1337. That simple. And launching Firefox, it's very clear that I am in Japan. Yeah, very clearly in Japan. I love it. So those are the steps across the board. Set up your SSH tunnel and then configure your proxy settings to look at your local host. Now that wasn't hard, right? It's kind of awesome. Now time for the second way, and it's actually also not very hard at all. This will involve setting up a shadowsocks server, which will be our socks proxy, and then we'll also install a shadowsocks client on our devices. And you can install that pretty much anywhere, Windows, Mac, Linux, and even your phone. And the server setup is stupid easy, especially on Linode, because Linode has a marketplace. And I can just go to the marketplace and search for shadowsocks. They've got a little item here to set up. All I have to do is put in my passwords, create a limited sudo user, a password for that user, and then region. Oh, another important thing to do. Oh, I wanna go to Mumbai. Yes. Again, shared CPU, lowest $5 a month. I'll call it shadowsocks Mumbai. Create a root password. All the passwords here. And then click on create Linode. It does everything for you. Little coffee break while it's brewing. NetworkChuck.coffee. Actually, while that's brewing, have you hacked the YouTube algorithm today? Have you liked the video? Hit subscribe. Hit that notification bell. Comment it. You gotta hack YouTube today. Ethically, of course. And actually, while it's provisioning, while it's brewing, we can install our client. I will have links for this below. I'll just go to shadowsocks on the interwebs, go to their GitHub, and I should be able to find, yeah, shadowsocks Windows here, and go to their latest release. Again, I'll link directly to this below. I'll download that zip, extract it here, and I'll run the exe. And that's literally all we had to do. Now it's waiting for our server settings, which are being set up right now. Let's go check it on it. I think it is done. I'm gonna go ahead and grab my SSH access, launch my terminal, and jump into that server. We're in. And to find our configuration for the server, I'm gonna use cat to look at a file, so the cat command. And I'll look in etc shadowsocks. What is it? shadowsocks-lib.dev. Let's see what's there. Oh, there it is, only one file, config.json. Let's cat that. Cool, there's our config. Now, I do need my password to be hidden, Nick. Two things you wanna point out. Here's our server port, which is 8000, and our encryption method, rather, AES-256-GCM. Remember that? We're gonna use that right now. I'll just grab my server IP address and get back into Windows and put that information in there. Port 8000, my password for shadowsocks. Encryption is AES-256-GCM, and that's all I have to do. Click on apply. Okay, now real quick, I'm gonna refresh what's my IP address. I should be back in Texas, back in good old Texas. So now I'm gonna go to the bottom right. I should have shadowsocks running in my tray. Just gonna click on that, or right click it, go to system proxy and say global. You'll notice it'll turn, is that blue? I don't know, I'm colorblind. The proxy's on, it's being used. So now if I refresh where I am, oh, there I am. I had to open up Chrome actually to get this to work. Firefox isn't configured to use a proxy right now. Chrome will use my system settings. And yep, there I am in Mumbai. That's pretty cool. And going to Google, let's see if it changes to whatever that is. Is it Hindi? I'm not sure what that is. Let me know below, guys. I'm not sure. Oh, actually, there's a lot. They're offering languages. It's more than just Hindi. I'm sure Hindi's in there. Now, setting up the shadowsocks client on every other device is pretty much the same. Inputting your server, your port, your authentication, or I'm sorry, your encryption method. And you can disable and enable it when you need to. And it will also be encrypting your traffic as well, which is kind of cool. combining the best of both worlds, VPN and proxy. So I would love to know if you set up your own proxy. Comment below. And also, I want to know your thoughts about Google baking in a proxy into their Chrome browser. I'm on the fence about it, but I want to hear your thoughts. That's all I got. I'll catch you guys next time.